you, Mr. Chairman, dear colleagues. It's really a very wonderful video. And I don't know, how could you find all these photos? And how could you choose this Chinese music? That is, I can assure you, I did not offer any photo to them. I did not offer any hint of my favorite song, but they have done a wonderful job. Thank you very much. Thank you. Mr. Chairman, Excellencies, Ministers and Ambassadors, Deputy Secretary General, and all three directors of the Bureau, newly elected and re-elected officials, heads of delegations, ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to bring the ITU Plenary Potential Conference 2022 to a close. Thank you to Prime Minister, His Excellency Nicole Inoue Chenka, for his inspirational video message about ITU's future. I'm very proud at this happy moment for ITU of what PP 2022 has achieved. We have adopted the strategic and financial plan for 2024 to 2027 by putting universal connectivity and sustainable digital transformation at the center of our strategy. We are sending the message that ICT and sustainable development for all go hand in hand. The more than 60 resolutions you have adopted, including new resolutions on key topics ranging from artificial intelligence technologies to space policy issues to mitigating global pandemics, will help build a global economy and a society that is more sustainable, more prosperous, more fair, and more connected. I'm grateful to Brazil, the United States, Guinea, Equatorial Guinea, Papua New Guinea, and Cambodia for increasing their contributions and encourage others to do the same. ITU needs your financial support. With our new financial plan and this increase of more than 12 contributory units, I'm pleased to leave ITU in a sound and a promising financial situation. I know the new management team will seize this opportunity and capitalize on these significant assets. Today, ITU has become a much valued partner on the global stage. That was evident in our participation in the advisory committee of the Transformation Education Summit that took place at the new United Nations in New York last month, where I also addressed the related gathering in the United Nations General Assembly Hall on this occasion. I also value my role in having BRICS, the G7, and the G20 start their ICT ministerial annual meetings in 2015, 2016, and 2017, respectively. ITU has actively participated in these meetings, oftentimes as a valued knowledge partners. I'm pleased that they have held these meetings every year since then, and plan to continue to do so in the future. Because 2.7 billion people are still unconnected, we just have 8 years left to have everyone connected. It is my hope that the progress accomplished at this PP and what you will do in Qatar in 2026 will allow us to declare victory when our union comes back together again in 2030. We need all the ideas we can get. And I know the new leadership team has a lot of ideas and initiatives, and is ready to work with you to take on this challenge. I call on you to advocate for an ITU that is both a technical agency and a development agency, and to strengthen this message inside and outside the ITU family. The election of the next ITU leadership team signals the beginning of a new era. I was pleased to see Madam Doreen Bogdan Martin become the first woman to be elected as ITU Secretary General. Madam Secretary General-elect, I wish you and your amazing team good luck and every success for the future. Let me also take this opportunity to congratulate all the new ITU Council member states and the chair and vice chairs of the Council, as well as the members of the Radio Regulation Board. I'm confident that this new leadership will take ITU to new heights. I'm also very much encouraged by the new generation of leadership among delegates on display at this conference. The future of ITU is in very capable hands. Since this is the last time I will address this plenary, I would now like to refer on my 36 years at ITU, including 24 years as an elected official. I just want to confirm I can also beat Malcolm Johnson for the longer year of activity in ITU, because I joined ITU first conference in 1979. And if we heard from Malcolm, he had 40 years activity engagement, but I have now 3 years even longer than him. I joined ITU in 1986, 1 year earlier than Chesapeake Lee. Then I was Secretary of Staff, and he was expert for our meetings. At that moment, 1986, there was no internet, and only a handful of countries had a very limited analog mobile phone service. Only 185 million people were online when I first got elected as TSB director in 1998, the year when the idea of holding a world summit on the information society was born. Today, 5.3 billion people are using the internet. 5G, AI, IoT, and broadband have all entered the mainstream vocabulary. Satellites, optical fibers, and submarine cables have brought continents, villages, and people close together. Over 3 decades, I witnessed firsthand how ICT innovations have changed the world, and how important ITU has been in advancing this digital transformation. Ladies and gentlemen, Romania has been an outstanding host. It was a common effort among their parliament, the Prime Minister's office, the Ministries of Foreign Affairs, Culture, and Research, Innovation, and Digitalization. And ANCOM and the Protection and Guard Services of Romania, SPP, as well as the local security team, health services team, help desks, all the volunteers, and my own security officials and driver. Our delegates are all impressed by the support, warmth, and hospitality of our host. This wonderful PP 2022 will leave delegates with many wonderful memories. Let us give everybody of them, the host, a huge round of applause. Thank you. Let's thank the chairs and vice chairs of the conference, the chairs and vice chairs of the committees and working group of the plenary, as well as the chairs of ad hoc and drafting groups and coordinators of informal discussion. Many among them are women experts and young delegates. Let's give them a warm round of applause. A big thank you to all the ITU staff who worked on this conference here in Bucharest or in Geneva or in our field offices, in particular those who served as the secretarial teams of committees, working groups of the plenary, ad hoc groups, as well as the logistics, IS, communications, security teams, interpreters, translators, captioners, speech writer, protocol officials, photographers, technicians, and others. Please also give them a warm round of applause. Now, like my deputy, I have three persons to identify. My special thanks goes to Beatrice Prussian. Who spared no efforts to address all challenges before and during PP 2022. She is simply excellent. Let's give her a big round of applause. Now, serving a total of 6 terms of successively as the TSB Director, then Deputy Secretary General, and Secretary General was a pride and honor of my life. My sincere thanks to the People's Republic of China for their trust and support they have shown me over last 36 years. Thank you to all ITU members and partners. I was very honored and immensely grateful to Rwanda's President, Mr. Paul Kagame, for awarding me the Akasiro Medal last June. Thank you to my fellow elected officials, the past and the current. I wish Malcolm and Chesapeake the best for their future. Thank you to all ITU staff. You are the best team anyone could dream of. I have made many friends over the years. Thank you all for the marvelous support and encouragement. Now, let me take another individual. Let me thank my longtime assistant, Morak Ser, who has devoted 42 years to serving ITU's top management on the 14th floor of the ITU Tower, the longest of all ITU staff today. Morak has been a constant and a trusted source of support and a legend in ITU. Since 2013, she has worked as my main assistant day and night, 7 days a week, without ever asking for any overtime compensation. She is a model of hard work and a sacrifice. I really admire her and thank her for her service. I wish her a long and a happy retirement. Where is Morak? Please stand up. Now I have another individual to thank. I want like to thank my dear wife, Ehua, who has been a rock in my life. Ehua was a civil engineer, but she did not hesitate to put her career aside to allow me to pursue my own work. She's always been supportive of me, even when she started having health issues in 2016 for several years. It would mean a lot to me if you could join me to give her a warm round of applause. I just got a medal from you. If you allow me, I will present this medal to her. She deserves it. Yeah, let's take a photo. Come here. All right. Yeah. Bye. Yeah, let me feel so far. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Last, but not least, or even more important, I want to recognize the chair of PP 2022, Mr. Sabin Shamas. From the time his nomination, he committed himself to our business by joining all major ITU events and the regional coordination and consultation meetings. He did it despite his busy schedule as a leading member on ICT of the Romania Parliament. His deep knowledge of our challenges and opportunities, remarkable management skills, and leadership, extraordinary commitments, and a wonderful personality are appreciated by all delegates. He's fantastic. I thank our chairman for all he has done for the success of PP 2022. So let's give him a round of applause. I will present him with ITU medal and my certificate of appreciation, but let me just finish my last paragraph. So dear delegates and dear friends, ITU has survived two world wars, the Cold War, many financial crises, military conflicts, and a political turmoil. In its long 157-year-old history. Throughout, we have remained at the cutting edge of innovation amid industry transformation. Like in all families, we have stood together in good time, sometimes hard times. If geopolitical conflicts are inevitable, we have always tried hard to focus and to maintain our core business. When I became Secretary General in 2015, I promised you I would work with you to create a harmonized environment for members and for staff. I've tried my best. I believe we will once more come out stronger and continue to build an even better future together. I have worked within ITU for 36 years without interruptions. I've spent half of my life with the ITU family. I love ITU I love you all. I will miss you. I wish ITU the best for the future. The world needs ICT, and the ICT needs ITU. Long live ITU. I still have to conclude. To conclude, I wish you a safe journey home, and wish you and your family all a happy and healthy, prosperous New Year 2023. Thank you very much. Now let me present my certificate and medal to our chairman.